he also, you know, no education, and after his life is quite interesting, very interesting. More read books, get information, and very interesting guy, very unusual guy. That's area focus. I just focus, then find out, then see what's up. Then after that, then one of the guy, then the, one of the, you know, director, whenever I did the movie, then he said, I never heard, but whatever you said, I have to research. Okay, go ahead, research. Then he spent the time, then the research. I don't know how many months research. Then we get together again. Then also, you think we make a movie or something? Then he said, I don't know. Okay, let's go mountain, you know, like a Korean mountain or something. So then pray about, think about, see what's the result. Then Monday he came back from the San Bernardino or whatever place. And, I came back, then we just get together. Then what do you think? You're going to make a movie or something? Then how about you? What do you think? Then we just see each other, talk each other. Then I said, I pray about, then I got a very strong impression from the Lord, the Holy Spirit, then we got to do. So he said, yes, I'm going to do. So we get together, the boss, okay, you have a money? Then he asked me, you have a money? I said, no money. Boss, we don't have a money or something. But if, you know, this one said God's work, then God provides all our need, which is in glory through Christ Jesus. After I believe it, then I started digging into the more, you know, story. So what's actually truth and everything. So today, you know, I'd like to briefly explain what Azusa Street. But Azusa Street is similar to Book of Acts. Okay? So I think, you know, today I just come up and then so much mystery. This title, The Mysteries of Pentecost Power, another word, Acts, Book of Acts, and also Azusa Street, you know, kind of connect. So that's why, you know, this is one event in the face of the earth, when 600 million people influence from the Azusa Street, 600 million people. Okay. 100. So that's why, you know, movie start, I really want to show, that's why, you know, first few minutes you watch, then you can see, you know, why I am so interested. So today, you know, we're going to look into the book, you know, this one. Then first maybe read a couple pages. So then we go to this title. The mysteries of Pentecostal power. Okay. So then we finished up then this book, second one, Azusa Street. Hi. Wow, skateboard lady. So much faster than the car, right? Nowadays. Yeah, in the downtown, people walk much faster than the car. Yeah. Okay. Here we are. Okay, let's start reading. You okay? Yeah. Why don't you just start reading the answers to read the Bible? Page 29. Okay, first, I think a few pages will be good. Then, jump on the mysteries of the Pentecostal power we're going to do. Yeah, page 29.
Yeah, okay. Let me read. Such an honor to have more of God's in my heart.
Seymour, yeah. He started praying and he's kind of crazy, but you know, like 5 hours a day, you know, then also 2.5 years, he concentrated the Spirit of the Lord. You know, that's what he started, yeah, from the prayer. He was born in 1870. And he died in 1922, 52 years. In the first, around 30 years old, he started looking more deeper and deeper, Spirit of the Lord. Yeah. Okay.
Many leaders emerged from the Ancestry Reviver, but the most significant person was the son of slaves William Joseph Seymour. Seymour was born in 1870 in
Louisiana,
and was raised in the Baptist Church. As a boy, he was spiritually inclined and had mystical experiences, dreams, and visions as another small pause left him lying in his left eye. To those who knew him, Seymour was a man of uncommon spiritual hunger.
Mm-hmm. So then, anyway, spiritual world, okay. Spiritual world, we talk about the hunger and the thirsty. Meaning is you know, something really, really happened in your mind. Like I got them. First, I went to the Little Tokyo. I watched then you know, bunch of the black people. You know, at the time I had no intention, no interest. But in my spirit, something okay, something in there. Even though nobody know. Very few people know, you know. So then, at the time, then really, my spirit hunger and thirsty. I like to know more. I like to see more. See what this guy looks like or something like that. Yeah. So then, the Bible. I want you to read the Bible, Matthew chapter 5:6. So this one's actually Jesus himself. Called the spiritual hunger and the thirsty, you know, at the moment. Matthew chapter 5. Okay, verse 6. Yeah, whenever open up. Huh? Verse 5 or 6, yeah. Verse 6. So chapter 5, verse 6. Righteousness. Yeah. So actually, this Jesus talk, Jesus actually talking something really, really, you know, hunger and thirsty. Like my case, that like I like to make a movie, you know, very inside my spirit, then really, I don't know what's actually result. I don't know how much I have. You know, I don't know anything about. But the inside is so hungry and thirsty. So then that's why Jesus said, if you look at hunger and thirsty for righteousness. Righteousness means is a relationship between God and yourself. Okay, and Jesus and you. You know, more like a personal relationship you got the one. So that's actually righteousness. Righteousness is right to stand with God. And that's the real meaning, but righteousness, you know. So then the, you know, so it will feel, mean satisfied. So that's why once you got the something hunger and thirsty, and step on, then toward the right things, you know. So that's. He moved in Cincinnati. Sanctification. Yeah. In the same. Doctrine preached by. Yeah. Okay. So that's John Wesley. Last week I explained to you guys. This is a very neat guy. And this guy's a really, really evangelist. And not just sit down in the office and the church. He go out. Then very much he got a spiritual experience. That's why he teach people spiritual discipline, you know, discipleship type of one. So then this guy's then the age of 25 years old, 1895, he was, you know, only 25 years old. At the time he got the job, then the kind of waitress type of one. Then, you know, very few people, you know, black people, can get the job at the time. So then he got the job. Then, you know, very fortunately, fashionable restaurant, kind of fancy restaurant. Then he worked. Then few years he worked. Then he moved next to step. Then he was an interesting, you know, like a young William Seymour. We don't see very many, you know, record or books or something like that. But he's a very much a spiritual inclined. He is a very much sensitive guy, you know, spiritually. So that's time, 1900, year of 1900, then start more Christian spiritual movement. Yeah. So then he likes John Wesley, Because he is more evangelist than he just go and talk and show the God. But John Wesley himself, and first he finished school, good school, Oxford, Oxford or whatever. He finished a good school, but really he cannot convince them Jesus Christ as a God more personal relationship with Jesus Christ. But anyway, he got the right track. He was right. And now, age of 33, okay, now Houston. Okay, go ahead, next page. So this guy is a Frederick Douglass, meaning against slavery. He just against slavery. Then William Seymour, he's a black, one eye guy, chicken pox or whatever. Then become one eye. So that's why, oh my God, this guy is a very powerful guy. Then he really involved his idea, his thought, and his philosophy, and he believing God or something. Yeah. Okay?
More of God was in my heart. Seeing me later said, there I prayed for $5 a day for 2.5 years. Those 3 years would soon show her effect.
Mm-hmm. So then I involved quite a bit Korean church. Because Japanese people almost nothing, in Christianity. Then so that's why I'm working pastoring now church in Korean church. Yeah. And Korean is very, very active, moving so much, positive way. Based on the Pray like a crazy, yeah. So that's William Seymour, he did himself. Then also he catch something, like a spiritual incline. That's one's more like a Holy Spirit he touch, So then he changed his life quite a bit, yeah. Okay, next one.
Charles
Hoffman. Yeah.
In 1905, Charles Hoffman, a white police teacher, came to Houston and conducted a citywide crusade in Brianna. Hoffman had begun preaching a controversial third blessing after.
Mm-hmm. Sanctification,
that the baptism in the Holy Spirit will be
tongue. Yeah. By speaking in tongue. Yes.
So how far many speakers use in the hostel, including signals, then is it only who quickly welcome his message? Where would you have such a friendship with Abraham? Did they invite you home to serve in the families to their children and return to their home in its first place? She turned her history of her
congregation yeah.
over to see your advice in the home in Texas Street. Since that experience, her own spirit disciplines could be us.
Yeah, this was actually very, very key word over here. Then he just don't know anything about, but anyway, he actually involved, you know, more spiritual world. Then he said the spiritual world is more than real world. Real world means we can see, we can hear, you know. So then his size of the spiritual world is very much like a more whole Bible, you know. That's what he got involved in this. Then he likes to, so then also so much he involved, you know, this spiritual, you know, area, because he prayed in 5 hours, 6 hours, and also you know, two and a half years, then straight, then non-stopping, you know, something like that. Something he found. He found God and the Holy Spirit. That's fine. So then, what's the actual evidence of the God? You know, evidence. He trying to find out, and lots of great teacher, you know, now she just read this page. You know, lots of people, you know, very much involved. And so that's why 1900 to this country is very much spiritual awakening. So that's what this story we are talking about. So then he just meet. Because of his spiritual maturity, then he meet lots of people who know the, you know, the whole world. You know, one of the guy, Seymour, meet Charles Palm. Yeah, so this guy's a big guy. You know, why you know, meet son of the slave and one eye and no education, but he got a very much you know, testified about him. You know, he got no education, nothing. Then he come from the you know, Indiana to Los Angeles, come to Los Angeles. Then he got no background, but the only his background is Jesus Christ behind him. Yeah. So that's why his evidence, he showed them spiritual kind of evidence, then showed to the people in Los Angeles, and getting gradually people in Los Angeles understand. You know. Okay, next page. More a little bit, okay. 1905, he was age 35 years old, okay. Yeah. Yeah, you know this law? This is a very crazy law. But actually, segregation of the black people. Black people is maybe second citizen or, I don't know, third citizen, you know. So then they don't admit as a citizen. This is a crazy law, but no more existing, okay? No more existing, but at the time, then this is a law. Yeah, then the black people and, you know, didn't have time at the time, but that's why he can't go into the white people's school. Or he can't take a seminary and all other study, even though he's so hunger and thirsty, but he can't go in. That's a law, you know, of the United States, this one. So lots of you know, law we have, segregation of the you know, black people, you know, born black means slaves, and also people come from the Africa, you know, ancestor, you know, father or grandfather or whatever. Then we put the label, this one, Jim Crow Law. So then that's what's 1905. Sima was age of 35, then he trying to study or learn something, but he can't do, you know, this one. Yeah. Okay, next one.
Laws and customs that how is currently these rules by allowing same one to see in an upstream woman is to the classes who are not coming to work. Here is a one in my teaching of baptism in the Holy Spirit, evidence by speaking in tongues.
Okay, very good. Yeah, so this one's a Seymour himself. He can't go into the class. People refuse because of the law, segregation, racial segregation law. So that's why he can't go in the class. So what actually he did, he just one of the teacher allow to him listen, but not get in the room, you know. So that's why some students open up a little bit the door, then he sit outside and listen what actually, you know, Holy Spirit, God, you know, some crazy things happened at the time, but anyway, that's just American history. This is almost 100 some years ago, you know, this country. Okay, next one. Okay. Invitation to Los Angeles.
While attending classes and continuing to pastor his graduation in Houston, Seymour was invited to pastor a Los Angeles Storefront Holy Mission whose parishioner was mostly black. This group had been expelled from the Second Baptist Church in Los Angeles because they accepted the Holy teaching of Second Blessing of Sanctification. One of the one of their members, Neil Kelly, has attended Seymour Church in Houston and was regularly impressed with him. She returned to Los Angeles and her church promptly invited Seymour to pastor their congregation. After prayerfully considering their offer, Seymour accepted it and departed Houston in February 1906.
Just 1 second, listen. So can you imagine this guy? He got no education, nothing. Then how much he knows in the whole Bible or God's grace and everything? Then law, this country, and the United States, Jim Crow law means racial segregation, totally segregated. I read more detail about this one, then more crazy this country, of course, than the second season at the time. But William Seymour, he never give up. He got the still hunger and thirsty. So he doesn't care other people. He likes to know what God really teaching me, my life or something. So then people understand, and white people understand this time. So that's why he was invited white church, then as a pastor. Can you imagine a pastor? Pastor is kind of very much special, class, early 1900. So then the people accepted. So that's much his depths of the spirit is very, deep. So you know, I can't express this one, but anyway. Whenever I made a movie, then I talked to people, then the kind of personal testimony, really some people met him while he was a small baby, and still remember something. So then we just interviewed then the guy who was almost 100 years old. Then he described, and my father said, or something, he never met, but my father said William Seymour, excellent, then unbelievable guy, this one. So that's why this description that I can't describe very much deeper, but just brief, ideas behind. Okay, go ahead to the next one. Seymour.
Seymour had not received the baptism in the Holy Spirit, but he was prepared to preach it without compromise. In the first service at the mission in Los Angeles, he broached the subject of the so-called third blessing, but his audience equated the Baptists in the Holy Spirit with their own experience of sanctification and rejected the idea that tongues was necessary. When Seymour returned in evening service, he found the door padlocked. The elder had decided he was preaching false doctrine less than a week. After arriving in Los Angeles, Seymour was without a church.
Yeah. Can you imagine? Sometimes, they don't understand spiritual level and inside the spirit. So he was, unemployment, in other words. He was invited by the folks from the Los Angeles. The first day he preached, he never compromised, you know, this Word of God. This Word of God, and actually New Testament, 2,000 years old, Old Testament maybe few thousand years old. Then he never compromised and thought, idea, and faith, and everything. So the people, you know, never heard. So then the automatically people reject him. So that first day he came, less than a week after arriving in Los Angeles, Simo was with a church. You know, described in Padua, and close, you know, church entrance door. Then he went there, and then he can't get in. You know, that was happening. You know, lots of story then beside you know, Seymour's, you know, black people in this country. Yeah. But anyway, Seymour's so much spirit to feel, but people don't understand. That's why people just reject. You know. Sometimes people think then the same doctrine or idea. They accepted, but this guy's a so pure heart guy, you know, pure heart. So then he just straight word of God and the guidance of the Holy Spirit. So then the people rejected. Yeah. Same thing like Jesus himself. Jesus only 30 years old, then started ministering only 3.5 years. Then the people understand. Then he showed the miracle and the wonder, you know. Then the people accepted. Oh, he's the Son of God, you know, Son of God. But after that, then the Pharisee or other lawmaker, then rejected Jesus, then you know, crucified, and yeah. Then after time, then so many people. You know, can you imagine 50,000 people, men and women, maybe 12,000 people, fed. Oh, this is a miracle. Jesus is a miracle, you know, performer or something like that. But after that, people just reject him. Even Peter is one of the disciples. He's a, you know, most wonderful guy. Then also, he's Peter is more close to the Jesus. He's a number one disciple. But once Jesus got crucified, you know, arrested, then immediately he just refused. Yeah, I never knew him. I don't know him. You know, that kind of thing. That's more human being, but anyway, Simon also, you know, he preach and teach, you know, this Word of God. So this was, you know, Word of God and written by John and Luke and Mark and Matthew, you know, all the Jewish people. Then the people rejected, yeah. So that's another thing that's quite interesting. Okay, go ahead, read the next one.
We have no grace for some member of the mission to confession on Simon and inviting him to stay in the homes of Edward Lee and then Richard Asbury, who live in 214 Bonnie Brea Street. Simon even combined on almost overwhelming hunger for the power of the Holy Spirit spent nearly all his time in prayer. He later said, I got Los Angeles, and there the hunger was not less but more. I prayed, God, what can I do? The Spirit said, pray more. Oh Lord, I'm praying 5 hours 5 hours a day now. I increased my hours of prayer to 7 and prayed on. I prayed to God to give what Parham preaching, the real Holy Ghost and fire with thorns, with love, and power of God like the apostle said. Because of Seymour's devotion to prayer, the Asbury's opened their home to evening prayer meetings. Seymour told the group about Lucy Fallow, who had introduced him to the idea of baptism in the Holy Spirit. They were so anxious to meet her that they took up an offering for her train fare and invited her to come. A few days later, Edward Lee returned home after work to find Barbara just arrived from Houston. He was so hungry for the baptism in the Holy Spirit that after the brief introduction, he implored, "Sister, if you lay your hands on me, I believe I will get my baptism right now." He replied, "I can't do it unless the Lord says so." Later, while eating dinner, Father rose from her seat, walking over to Lee, and said, "The Lord tells me to lay my hands on you for the holy bath." He laid hands on Lee, who immediately fell out of his chair and, while lying on the floor, began speaking thumbs. As the people came in, they would fall under God's power, and the whole city was still. They shouted there with the foundation of the house gave way. A new song, when revival break out at the Benny Blair Street home of Richard and Ruth Asbury on April 9th, 1906. Jenny Seymour, she played the piano and sang the street, never having had lesson.
Yeah, this was a Benny Blair. Okay, Benny Blair, you know the street? You know, right? Yeah, street, then the, just five, six minutes from here. You know, still existing. So one of the preacher, he bought a house. Then I just look at the, you know, my video, shoot inside the Barney Blair's house, yellow house. Okay. So then the, you know, preacher said, I mean, the pastor said, no more, you know, taking a picture. So that's why this is the last one, you know. I took a picture inside the house. So then the William Seymour's wife, Jenny Moore, then she never ever had any experience with music. You know, never play a piano or something. But actually, God gave direction and teach her. Then she became leading a music director. She never went to school. She never learned or practiced something. So that's why his whole ministry, you know, 1906 to 31. If you go to the downtown Los Angeles.